of my head! I already told you! I will not be distracted from this anymore! I won't! It will take more than headgames to stop me. You may have invaded my mind and my body, but there's one thing to say and always keep. It's true!
You may be asking yourself, why did I use the Dragon Ball Z reference in that little opening skit? I chose to use that because in the year of the monkey, 1980, was when Akira Toriyama first made his award-winning series, Dr. Slump, and Dr. Slump is what helped launch his career as a manga artist, and I am very thankful for Dragon Ball Z introducing me to manga and anime, so I decided to give it some type of fucking shout-out. That aside, let's get into this Bleach review. I might need Watson's help to solve this mystery. Is either to cure the dead, or isn't he? The chapter starts off with an announcement. Says that in the third district, 27 soldiers are dead. Yeah, 27. People are getting fucked up. And then it's announced that a lot of people from the third division are fucked up. Their races have disappeared. Then it's been announced that Kida's spiritual pressure had disappeared. And Rose is like, I see. And then after that, it's a title page, and the name of the chapter is called Bleeding Guitar Blues. That shit sounds awesome. It sounds like it would be the title of, like, you know, fucking, like, if Jimi Hendrix was still alive, that sounds like it would be one of the title of his albums. Or it seemed like it would be the title of, like, Bruce Springsteen's album, something like that. It's a real cool looking title page. You see Rose in his little getup, and it's a cool sounding title page, actually. Leading Guitar Blues, that shit sound gangster as hell. And then in the next page, they show Violent Wright Quincy, and he kind of has a weird design to me. His hair is kind of standing up on end, like Kenpachi shit. And he got either like the biggest fucking goggles I've ever seen, or it's just something obscuring his face. I don't know what that is. And his name is Na 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 Najaku. Judging by the U, we can only come to the conclusion that that is his rank, using the alphabet A through Z. I'm just wondering though, like, is it the lower you go, the higher your rank? You know, because in some, like, games and, you know, some forms of anything, Z is like the highest level that you can be. Or, in some cases, if they're going backwards, A is the high level that you can be. Or if you want to go by Yu Yu Hakusho rules, S is the fucking highest level that you can be. But whatever. I'm just wondering, how is this rank divided up, considering that he's letter U? You know, I just wonder, like, where does he fall? Like, if you had to categorize him, would he be, you know, on the lower end of the spectrum, or would he be on the higher end of the spectrum, seeing that he's closer to Z but furthest from A? And that's just something I want to know. And then there's a bunch of back and forth dialogue between Rose and Master P. That's what I'm gonna call Na Na Na. I'm gonna call him Master P. There's a bunch of back and forth dialogue between those two, and Rose is saying something to the effect of, like, my flying V is mourning Killer, if he is dead. You know, if he's dead, then you guarantee that you're going to be fucked up because we are mourning right now. Watching Killer pretty much made melodies and it brought tears to me just to know that he was hurt this way. And Master P's like, well, you and your flying V thing, you don't have to worry about crying no more because you're going to be dead in 5 fucking minutes. And then Rose is like, you really ain't artistic at all, dude. Like, who wouldn't be crying after they see this many dead comrades? That shit that Rose said to Master P was probably like one of the most epic things that I've read. I mean, it's like, usually the good guys don't talk that way to the perceived antagonist. They usually say some type of goody-goody, good boy type shit, but now it's almost like, you know what, we throwing that out the bag. I'm getting fucking sick of y'all. You hurt my homie. I'm just gonna destroy your ass. And then we see a bunch of Shinigami, and they're like, I was a warrior once, but then I took an arrow to the neck. And then we're introduced to Stern Ritter, letter F, who I'm gonna call Skyrim, but his name is Asnot. When God is gone and the devil takes hold, who have mercy on your soul. And then one of the Shinigami's like, it's like our attacks don't even work, and everyone who gets stabbed by those shiny spike things dies instantly. When I saw that, I said, wow, that's fucked up. That's fucked up. Like, I don't even know what those spikes are, but an instantaneous death, like, it's fucked up on two levels. It's like, one, you're getting taken out by a spike. And two, you're getting taken out by a fucking spike. I mean, Jesus Christ. I don't even know if those things have, like, reishi inside of them. But it's just a spike, and they're just dying right away. And one of the guys just starts screaming. And another guy tried to run. And Shinigami's like, man, fuck that. We ain't no bitches. We don't run. Even if we don't die, we don't fucking run because we ain't no bitches. Don't retreat. We don't run. Don't retreat. And then all of a sudden, a sword just smashes into the ground, like right in between the Shinigami and Skyrim. I would really like to know who that is. Here's Renji! And then after Renji shows up or whatever, they cut to another page, and then we see Stern Ritter Quincy E. Her name is Bombayetta Basterbine or Basterbine, I'm assuming. Fuck that. I'm gonna call her Carly. And she just pretty much just ripping shit up, and then as she's ripping up shit, Kumamura comes and he's like, the enemy's even using little girls as warriors. And then she retaliates with, they even made a little puppy like you a captain. Soul Society must really be hurting for people. And I'm like, damn, dude, that's just like a straight kick to your balls, buddy. And then we see that various Shinigami are paired up with various Vondorak Quincy's. We see Shuhei and some big fucking gorilla looking dude. We see Shunsui with some old looking Professor Quincy. We see we see Soifone with some knight looking Quincy. He got a mask on. He looks like an English knight. We see Jushiro, and we see the back of the head of the person he's fighting. We see Toshiro, and the Quincy that he's fighting is so far away that it doesn't make sense. Where the fuck is Kenpachi? Like, why the fuck isn't he paired with anybody? I see them, but I want to know what Kenpachi is, because he would just be raping shit up if Kenpachi was there. What the fuck? And then it cuts back to Renji, and he's fighting Skyrim, and he's really trying to figure out, like, what abilities this guy has, because, like, every time he cuts him and shit, he blocks it, like, with his hand, but you see, like, some type of pattern on his arm, and it just kind of lights up and shit. And he's trying to figure out, like, what that is. And so he's like, maybe if I attack faster, he won't have time to do that shit. Then all of a sudden, we see fucking, like, a Spanish fucking wrestler just jump from behind him and try to attack him. Hulk! Smash! And Benji dodges El Toro's attack, and he's like, damn, he fast. And then we see that El Toro is trying to reach for him again, try to crush him. And then he gets, like, his hand gets, like, shot by, like, a beam or some shit. And then somebody says, you need not try and read him, Reggie, or take pity on him. And then I'm like, I would really like to know who that is. Right there is another example of what I'm talking about with the protagonist having those cold ass baller ass lines. I mean, Byakuya always have been a cold motherfucker, so I'm not shocked that he said that, you know, but it's just the dialogue was just so on point and everything was just right. This whole chapter was just like of epic proportions. Everything that was done was right, the drawings were right, the dialogue was excellent. The visuals was excellent. Everything was just on point. And I really have to say that this arc is like really, really shaping up to be the shit. And I'm loving it right now, man. If you could, give me a thumbs up. You know what I'm saying? That really helped me out. And if you could, drop a comment in the box below. And subscribe and all that stuff. And I will see you guys next Wednesday.